Hello, everybody. It's the man with, once again, the sorest throat of them all. How's it going? Welcome to the last Toy 4 A to Z of the year. And today, we're gonna make it a special one. It's gonna be great, epic. Sure will be a crazy one. So you're new around here, you want to know what's going on? Hoi4AZ is where I play every single starting nation in Heartsvine 4. I've been doing it for the past year and I'm just over halfway through. Soon enough, I will be done with the challenge and we are currently on the little N. For no please, I can't take any more. And today, can you spot the country we're going to be playing? I sure as hell can't spot it because it's so out of the way and ahead of it. Sorry, my Kiwi brothers, but your country's not exactly the best in Hoi 4. I will just politely say that this does suck. And I have gone over how bad the New Zealand focus tree is before, but today we're really going to experience it. And I thought, since we are playing a out-of-the-way nation in an out-of-the-way world, why not go ahead and take another viewer suggestion? Now, I don't know which one of you little Timmies was talking out of your behind before, but apparently, if I actually go down here, turn off historical AI, and then put these all to random, that they will actually do a bit more of a randomized focuses and not just the same stuff we usually see. Which means, yes, the Great New Zealand Spectator Game is about to begin. Now, this does mean that either Australia or Britain could do one of their focuses, which put me at war with them, but honestly, it's all part of the experience. Yeah, that's right, little Timmy. I do read your comments with your little suggestions, so make sure you always keep them coming, except the ones that tell me to jump off a bridge, because I'm already listening to that one in my head. Just kidding. I love Hoi 4. It's great. As you can see, I already have quite a few saved presets here, so I'll follow the tradition. All right, so now we should be in a truly randomized world with randomized chaos, and we are going to enjoy it. Wink. Now, all of the Together for Victory focus trees are a little bit janky in their own ways. The Australian one, kind of boring, doesn't give you a lot to do. The New Zealand one, pathetic. The Indian one, forgettable. South Africa, actually somewhat decent. And then the best one of all of them is Canada. As you remember from a great Canadian video, this one was a lot of fun. But sadly today, we're in New Zealand. So for our main things we can do here, we can obviously stay with the Commonwealth, which I don't think we're gonna do. Or we can go ahead and break free from Britain and get a whole whopping 4 fascist focus trees. Or you could just become independent and then do nothing. I guess one interesting thing you can do with the communist one is join the Comintern though, but considering Russia will be randomized, I don't know if there will be a Comintern. But for the most part today, we're just gonna go ahead and try to survive, which, will that be possible? We'll find out, I suppose. Do want to go ahead and reiterate that it is a little tough for me to talk right now. On Christmas Day, Santa brought me tonsillitis. It's been fun. And the real sad part about all of this is no matter what we had as New Zealand in the past, we no longer have it because with the new DLC, we don't have the basic tank templates, which means no Bob Semple or Big Bob. I guess, sure, you could create your own, but, yeah, we're not going to. Instead, hopefully, we shall watch the world burn and go to chaos from the safety of New Zealand. Please don't come back to bite me in my little Kiwi butt. Ooh, well, immediately, Kingdom of Poland. We're gonna get ourselves a monarch on the throne. So you people always want me to go ahead and, you know, actually pay more attention to the events. And when you play Hoi 4 like 10 billion hours, okay, you do start paying attention to these, okay? Just comes with the pro expertise of being unable to read. That's right. Playing grand strategy games will eventually melt your brain and these little symbols won't mean anything. What could they mean? Well, yeah, that was just Turkey remilitarizing the Strait and the German Civil War, which is to be expected. They need to do this to get to their, non-historical side of their folk tree, which is over here, where they can either do the Kaiserreich or go Democratic Germany. I don't know exactly what we're going to do yet. I was kind of waiting to see what Britain would do, but so far, they haven't made any big money moves over here. So I'll wait a second or two, just in case I do end up staying with Britain. But I guess we'll do some cool economic focus tree stuff instead. Okay, every damn focus tree. Okay, they're always like, what do? We can't think of anything cool to put in there. You know what? Just give them a nuke one. Oh, looks like they went with the Cossack king himself. And I haven't seen anything else crazy happening in the world so far. It's suspiciously quiet. Why on earth does New Zealand have more war support than the UK at the start of the game? We're ready for a fight. Oh, well, you're not usually there, are you, Alf? Oh, we got the Thunder Cross Latvia has broken free. There he goes, Mr. Gustav himself, the angry librarian. Uh-oh, the Mexican junta's broken free. We saw how that went one time, didn't we, America? Can you please save us this time, Alf? Is Germany under attack? Germany is... Okay, Germany. Well, and there goes the little Entente as well, and... how did you get involved in this again? All right, I should click through something there. And yep, Germany is now in the government of national defense, which I am pretty sure is communist China's faction. Oh, and yeah, also, yeah, it looks like, Japan didn't do too well. And I ain't even sure about this one either. I think I missed something here. And did somebody say Democratic Germany? How fun! But we did get ourselves a Nation Francaise, which I'm pretty sure is the... Yes, okay, that's something different. Okay. Wasn't expecting that one. Oh, and the Entente, the little Entente, I want to say, not the normal Entente that you know, has actually declared war on Poland. That's interesting, but also... Somehow France got involved, so I guess the Polish declared war on them because the French guarantee was probably still on them. All right, well, we're going to have to see what happens here. Maybe Poland will just eat all this land up or they get pushed back. Time will tell. All right, yeah, okay, the UK has finally picked the path themselves, and I think I've decided where I'm going. Oh, apparently Poland's picking off even more land there, and the anarchists have won in Spain. So, yeah, things are getting spicy. Why did you declare war on Estonia? You can't get to Estonia. Things are getting even more complicated over here because the Soviet part of Mexico just broke free. who would have thought the China-Japanese war would really spread this far, eh? Yeah, sorry, Brent. I gotta go eat my homework. My dog ate my homework. I gotta go leave. The dog's eating the homework. The dog's gone fascist. I gotta leave. All right, like 50 things just popped off. So Turkey's in a civil war, Portugal's in a civil war, and Poland's now allied with Italy. Things are getting very spicy, but we're playing New Zealand. New Zealand is not spicy. Oh, well, yeah, once again, things are, getting bigger in Europe. Getting bigger and more confusing. Germany, still just part of the government of national defense. I always love this Turkish leader. Look at him. He's just like, hey, 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 hey. Oh, well, yep, there goes Portugal. Welcome to anarchism, my friend. Still just vibing over in New Zealand, though. I think everyone's forgotten we exist. I forgot we do get two little light cruisers from Britain, though, for our focus. So I guess I'll bring these bad boys over and, well, nothing. I'm not going to do anything with two light cruisers. Oh, it does look like the Polish are making a breakthrough, though, especially with the power and help of the Italians. But obviously, once again, as usually happens, the Italians are stalled over here on the mountains, which, even more so this time, because I guess the French don't have to worry about the Germans. They may have taken away the big bob, but at least we still have the big bob tank focus. Oh, okay, yeah, I missed this one. It's happening again. It's actually happening again, America. Come on, ow! I also have no idea what happened over here in the China war. It just came to a complete standstill a while back, and the border has now moved. I guess it is pretty gnarly over here, eh? Oh, would you look at that. Poland do be going. They be going hard. Oh, there goes Romania, which means the Polish and the Italians are now kissing each other. And just got the Czechs, the Greeks, and the French left, and we might have peace already in Europe. Mr. Chamberlain, you ain't looking, too democratic. Well, I had no idea what I was expecting. America, you suck. Oh, but maybe a momentary saving grace for them, because US is now in the Allies, but the Allies isn't about to be the ally. I don't think they can call me in, because I am a Dominion now, so I'm pretty sure I have to accept, hopefully. I don't want to be at war with Mexico. Although, it doesn't look like these are Mexican troops to me. They seem to have a funny little German flag over them. Alas, I have been dragged in against my will. Question is, though, is the British and all the Commonwealth reinforcing going to be enough to actually save the Americans here, or is it going to be too little too late? Something I never thought I'd see is Communist China, North Dakota. Why did they give them the land? America has fallen. Was it really worth it, UK? It definitely wasn't worth it for me. They also pieced down a little Entente now. And yeah, that's a really big Poland. Still a war with France though. So maybe something interesting might happen. Like the Polish going to war with the Germans. Or the French going to war with the Germans. Or the Italians going to war with the Germans. We'll never know. Oh, and yep, there goes North America. Okay. What's your plan now, Britain? Right, Mr. Chamberlain. It's my turn to say goodbye, Fott. Apparently Italy's declaring war on us, so that's gonna be interesting too. Just Britain getting even more kicked in. Oh, Italians on the UK, and the Soviets just declared war on Poland. Okay, things are getting spicy. Actually, no, they're already very spicy. My mouth starts to burn. Does anybody have a glass of milk? Pretty please, may I have thy Pacific Island? Oh my god, they said yes. They all said yes. Look at that. New Zealand, big! I guess the worst part about this, though, is that they are all occupied states, which means we now have to put people there. Not a lot, because there is a lot of compliance in a few of them, but not in Hawaii. And yeah, we went to war with France and Japan. We could unite Polynesia, but that's not gonna happen. And we now live in the cursed world where Italy is too damn powerful. Oh yeah, I'm also a communist now, by the way. Don't I look pretty? You know what? I'm just gonna save myself the headache of dealing with all of this getting blown up. And I think we're just gonna release a few of these people and have them as puppets. There we go. Now we got the rightful leader of Hawaii in charge, Charles Fujimoto. So one thing we can do in our allied faction to somewhat help them is actually build a railway up to the front line in North Africa. Can't say we're not good for something over here. Ah, yes, the UK pressures the Regional Defense Council of... Well, they're definitely embracing anarchism, aren't they? There it is. Anytime anyone asks you to point Communist China out on the map, just take a screenshot of this and say that's where it is. Yeah, looks like Poland's not doing too well. I'm pretty sure Soviets did just straight up go the historical path, and it's paid off for them. I went ahead and took the ideological loyalty little bonus over here, which gives us weekly manpower 500, and I'm actually quite up there with the manpowers now. The rest of the world is just fleeing the chaos that has ensued everywhere. Oh my god, I just keep looking away. Looking back, Communist China keeps getting larger. And yeah, Soviets have well and truly rolled over the east here, and they are not done just yet. Like how Italy was going through here to invade Turkey, the Soviets just carried on down in them and just encircled the whole land here. Yeah, you may be controlling most of Europe there, Mussolini, but you still ain't too smart, are you? Iran joined the Czech Entente. That's not the Czech Entente. The Czechs are dead. You ever just wonder why this button is even in the game? It just, it does nothing. Paradox. Paradox? Well, looks like the old British are doing a D-Day. Not too sure how well it's gonna go for them, but if they do manage to pull this off at any point, that does mean that they can walk straight into Germany, as the French are also at war with the Germans. As we just saw, it's probably gonna take a little bit more than that, but the Soviets are on their way too. Meanwhile, in New Zealand, though, nothing. This is about to get messy, because if they capitulate, that means France will be free and probably just get rolled over by Germany. Yeah, it would be good if the British kind of just swarmed the beaches here and overthrew France while they could, but this is a computer program made by a bunch of Swedish people, so not gonna happen. No logical sense here. Oh, you gotta copy me, do ya? You're also a little bit late on that one, mister. Well, it happened, and my theory does not matter, because I did not realize the Soviets are also at war with France. Give me strength. All right. You need to stop, buddy. And the only thing that really could change the, well, change, get us out of this war now, is if the Soviets go in on the Germans, because I don't think the British AI is ever going to do it. And New Zealand definitely isn't going to do it. Although they still would have to somehow capitulate the Mexican Soviet Republic and the communist Chinese Canada. Oh, well, might be finally over for me. I think how the Germans had the effort to ship a railway gun to the front line over here. Well, peace has been concluded. I think, am I still at war with them though? I'm still at war with India and Japan, apparently. Oh. Peace has been concluded. Well, I said I was going to play to 1945 in my head, and this is 1945. I don't want to play anymore. Yeah, unsurprisingly, New Zealand's kind of sucks. I didn't think I'd even capitulate. Well, not capitulate. I didn't think I'd be involved in the peace deal, but I guess I was involved in the peace deal, even though I think my vassals, apparently they were free. But yeah, that was a interesting game. It was New Zealand, where we randomized everything, and once again, it just tended to go to hell. I think next time I do a historical AI off, I'm going to go ahead and just select the focuses on the paths I want to go down myself to think what'll make it most interesting. But yes, until next time, everybody, this will be the last Hoi 4 A to Z of the year, and probably the last episode, the video, of the year too, which is crazy. I hope you all had a very nice 2021. It's been pretty tough on all of us, but let's just hope 2022 isn't that bad. Shouldn't say that out loud, should I? And there probably won't be that many videos in January, as you know, most people, if you know your YouTubers, the CPM and stuff like that in January kind of sucks for YouTubers, putting a lot of effort and not a lot of reward back for it, but I'll still be uploading here and there. I'll just be taking a break since we went very hard in December. And next video will probably be the Q&A. If you've already answered, you asked a question, you know where to ask them. I won't be taking any more questions in the comments down below, but if you find the posts where I said I'm asking for questions, then you can go ahead and ask one. So maybe you should follow my Instagram, social medias, Twitters, and other such delights down below in the comments. And the description, and you'll get questions answered, maybe. Anyway, my brain's rotted, okay? I need to take a few days off. I'll catch you all in the next time, guys.